Guys, all my dreams are about to come true. This video will have a lot of content, so it's gonna be long, but bear with me because everything I'm about to tell you is just mind-blowingly cool and amazing. Trust me. So, where to start? So as you might know, the past 3 months in Nicaragua were pretty like shit to me. I was really heartbroken and shit like that. And I was like in this negative energy attracting all like really negative things. Like I got fired from my voluntary position. My microphone broke again. And what else? All this shit. And that's when I realized like, hey, I need to stop this because just being in a bad funk, complaining, thinking like bad stuff, is just attracting more negative energy because I believe in the universal energy and law of attraction. So when I came to Costa Rica, I was like, okay, Sandra, now let's try to be positive. Don't complain. Don't talk about Las Penitas anymore and the shit that went down. Just like I've been watching these like law of attraction videos and like how to kind of make your mind more in tune with like how you should be. And already in Las Penitas, when Oti texted me like, hey, I have a room for you and I actually even might have a job for you, that's when my friend Jenny told me like, Sandra, there's like so many good things happening for you. Like, and this is just the beginning. And let me tell you, she was damn right. It was only the beginning. Because after that, like, I don't know. Like just really good stuff happening. Like I've been asked on dates, like having free lobster dinner, free cab rides. Daniel, who I just went to Monteverde yesterday with, he rented the car because I'm like, hey, I'm saving money. So he's like, no worries, I'll pay for the car. And then like my coworkers like giving me free cake because I felt really sad. And like all these tiny little things are happening and just being like, fucking amazing because like universal energy, positive things that I'm attracting. So now this leads to what happened yesterday and what like is about to happen in the future. It's just crazy, let me tell you. So I know some of you are not into law of attraction, universal energy thing, but I want to give you a backstory so that all this makes sense, kind of. So bear with me. So all my dreams are about to come true. When I was coming to Costa Rica from Nicaragua, I made a list because I realized like, hey, the past 3 months, I was just concentrating on this guy and I completely forgot about myself. And like, what are my dreams? Like, what do I want to do in the future? And because like my future just seemed so unknown. I didn't have any plans. So I listed down all the dreams that I've had, you know, like, okay, I want to visit this place. I want to visit these countries. One of my dreams, okay, I want to sail from Central or South America to Australia, inspired by my friend Jasmine who once did it. I'd like to do this and that. I'd like to live here. And actually, then I stopped. I was like, no, I don't want to live here. I will live here. That's how I wrote it. Anyway, I'm on this website, findacrew.net, where you can look for a boat or a crew. So I've been there, like I've had my profile up and I've been basically like, yeah, I'm traveling in Central America, like looking to get to Australia. So this one guy contacted me and he's like, hey, I'm looking for crew, like another videographer. And basically he offered me a spot on his ship, on his boat. But not only that. So he told me like, hey, I need someone to come with me on the sailing boat. And I'm like, where are you going? He's like, okay, I'm sailing from Central America to Marquesas. I had to Google where that is. It's in French Polynesia. And he's like, yeah, how can I make this work for you? And I'm like, well, my final destination has always been like Australia. And he's like, well, we're going to Australia. And I'm like, no way, that's so sick. And he's like, okay, so could you come? I'm like, well, I need to make money. He's like, dude, I live in Canada, in BC, in British Columbia, and you could literally come work in my restaurant, like, as a waitress. Like, you'll make hours plus tips, like, around $18 an hour, and you'll get free accommodation, and, like, it would be from June to September, and then you could come with us to Baja California, and we'll be there for the diving season and we're filming everything. So if you can like help me out, like filming and uploading on YouTube and editing, then you have like all your expenses covered. You basically just need to chip in for food. And I'm like, what? Are you serious? So basically I'm going to go with, I think I'm going to go work to Canada in like this island, which has always been my dream. I've like since 1.5 years when I was working in the city of Espoo and we had these like summer trips, we went on like our, in, we went to an island in Finland and I was like, whoa, it would be so sweet to like live in the archipelago of Finland or like just somewhere, not like a tropical island, but kind of like, you know, this same kind of climate as Finland, like that kind of an island. And now it's about to happen. Like I would live on Desolation Sound, which is an island in British Columbia, work there, save roughly like $10,000 Canadian dollars, go to Baja California, which is somewhere I've always wanted to go in Mexico. And then there's this guy who's working with Matt, the captain, and he does free diving. So he would like teach me how to free dive, which has always also been my dream. I have asthma, so I've been thinking like that would be really good, just like broaden my lung capacity. And we'd be filming, seeing whales, spearfishing. I love that shit. Like I love fishing. Sorry, animal lovers. We would stay there for 2 months because that's like diving season. The water is super clear. And then we would make our way down Central America, like stopping Guatemala, Nicaragua, and like from Costa Rica or Panama, we would sail to Marquesas during, wait, I have all this down written down because we just had a Skype meeting. So we would, in March or April, we would sail to Marquesas, which is like a 3 week period of time that we would be on the sea, like without land. So we would get there by April and then just like island hop and make our way to Tahiti by June. And that's when we would leave the boat there. And then it's like from June to September, we have another period where you can go somewhere for work. So I could basically go back with him to British Columbia to work at the restaurant and live for free. Or maybe I want to go back to Finland to see my family and like work. But anyway, that would be like June to September. And in September, we would get back to Tahiti. And then from there, we would freaking sail for 8 months, like Vanuatu, Fiji, Solomon Islands. I asked if we could go to New Caledonia because that freaking place sounds so amazing. The name sounds so cool. So 8 months of sailing and we would make our way down to Australia or New Zealand in June 2019. So, oh my God, I know this video is so long, but guys, this is everything that I always wanted. Like, I can't believe that I've attracted all at once. Like, oh, just like finding a way to make money without going back to Finland. Living on an island, not a tropical island, but an island, just to like experience like how is it to live like in an isolated area. Then like learning how to free dive, learning how to sail, sailing from Central America to Australia, and just like working as a videographer. Because if I work with him and we upload on YouTube and there's other platforms, he has like this vision that we can completely like make ours, so mine and his, Matt's, travel very affordable. So we only need to like pay for our food. And if we have done our work right, then that means that the channel and all the videos and everything will pay for our plane tickets from Tahiti back to Canada or wherever. So what the fuck universe, I'm so grateful. Like I had no idea. I've been like, I can't believe this, because literally I'm not making these things up, but I have like, okay, check out, this is my desktop. I've made this mood board of my dreams. So, okay, so it's super, super crowded. But look here. Do you see? This is South America. But basically, I was like, South or Central America and sail to Australia. So there it is. And look, that's another thing that's like YouTube filming. So like, just, you know, working as a videographer, editor, building my portfolio. What the hell? And like, even this freediving shit, this is everything that I've thought about and wanted, and it's happening. It's happening. It's crazy. And I don't know if it's because like for the past 2 weeks I've really made an effort to try to not be negative. I've had my really bad days, but like I've been watching these videos like how to set yourself in the right frequency and everything, and universal energy is really working hard, like in a good way for me right now. So my next step is to see how could I get to Baja California, because I should go there before June, like very latest in May, just to see that how it is to live on the boat. Do our like chemistries work out with Matt? He seemed like a really nice laid back guy, so I think I'm gonna do it. And I'm just so excited. I have like so many cool things coming up in the next months. I've been like trying to think what I want to do if I go to Canada in June. So like I have 4.5 months. No, actually I have 5 months, because it would be mid-June when I would go to Vancouver. So I have so many things. I will tell later about these things because this video is already too long. But guys, don't stop being positive and dreaming and believing things happen, and like make mood boards. Things really happen. I can't believe, like, you might think, why am I not excited? It's just because like I can't even comprehend that all my dreams are becoming true at once. I mean, I still have more dreams, but these are like crazy big ass dreams. I don't know even how to end this. Like, oh, life is so good. Thank you, universe.